All right, so you're welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you've been using vMix and whenever you try to stream at the same time record using vMix on your system, it has been lagging and your recording is not stabilized, don't worry, because in this video I'm going to show you how to actually fix that and stabilize your vMix software to enable you to use it on your PC to record and stream at the same time smoothly without having to experience lagging or maybe difficulties on it. Okay, that's what I'm going to share with you in this particular video. I'm just going to go ahead and open the vMix software on my system. Okay, so I'm just going to open that and show you some of the things I did to be able to fix this problem. Okay, so I was also facing it as well on my PC, trying to stream and record at the same time using vMix. It keeps on lagging, and the problem is really a bit difficult for me. But I'm just going to share with you some of the tips, like the things I did to be able to fix that particular problem on vMix. Okay, so the first thing we are going to do is to click on the settings. You can see here. So once that is up, go over to your performance here, just here, and always make sure these two options are not turned on. Okay, so make sure these two options are not turned on. And if you use a high definition system that uses two graphics, like Intel and Nvidia graphics, also you can also from here select whichever one you want to use. As you can see here, mine uses only one graphics, which is the Intel HD graphics 530, because that is it here. And then the next thing you're going to do is go over to display. Okay, go over to display and reduce your output size. Okay, so reduce your output size, just make sure, just reduce it. Sometimes it's on 1080, you see it's always on 1080, but you can reduce it to 720, reduce it to 720, and the frame rate, keep it as low as you can, maybe about 25p. You can see, just keep it as low as you can, about 25, that is it. And when you are bringing in your capture card to vMix, always make sure you keep a low resolution, like the same as the display. Let everything be the same. Okay, so that will help to lower the lag or whichever problem you are facing with it. So it will help to use less of your system CPU. Okay, so just make sure you lower the resolution. If your graphic card or your capture card support 1080, you can just reduce it to 720 as well, and let the frame rate be as low as possible, maybe about 25, same as the display. Okay, so it won't be processing another thing here and then be processing another thing there also. And then secondly, make sure your internet, the internet you're using, is direct. Okay, so it's best you use a direct network instead of Wi-Fi. If you're using Wi-Fi to stream, that is bad, like very bad. So to make sure you use a direct in the network, okay, like the normal internet cable from your big modem you use to the system plugin directly, instead of using Wi-Fi to stream. Okay, Wi-Fi will make the whole situation worse. Just test, go to this side, let me just show you, sorry for that speed, to always test that your network speed. Okay, so test your network speed. I'm just going to run the text now. Your network speed here, that's the download speed and the upload speed. You can see the download speed is currently about 12.11, still going down. Let's just see what is download speed is, and also what the upload speed is. That will give us a clear picture of what a video bitrate to select when we are streaming on vMix. Okay, I see here, that's finished. Our download speed is 11.75 Mbps, and the upload speed is 6.76 Mbps. If you're using Wi-Fi and there's other network connected to it, that will lower the upload speed. Okay, remember, it will lower the upload speed. But if you're using it direct, it means you're using 7.76 Mbps. And when you are selecting your video bitrate on vMix, knowing fully where you have 6.76 Mbps as your upload speed, to give you a clear picture of what video bitrate to select. Okay, so you can select either, you can go with 1.5, and you can go with a minimum of 2,000 video bitrate as well. Okay, so and when you are using it, don't use it on Wi-Fi. Don't always stream your using vMix on Wi-Fi. Make sure it's direct. That will help you to utilize the upload speed, okay, properly, and it will help your stream to work perfectly fine. Sorry, to work perfectly fine. And also do the same thing for YouTube. When you're setting up your second streaming, make sure you select use stream one quality so that you can use the first stream quality you set up for Facebook or whichever one is your primary streaming here at the first one across the second and the third one as well. Okay, so that is what I've tested and it worked really fine for me. And when you're setting up your streaming on vMix, if you have the hardware encoder enabled, you always see the option down here, hardware encoder enabled, always tick that option. Okay, so you will see that somewhere here. So my laptop is not dedicated graphics, that's why you can't see it here. Always enable that option. Okay, always enable that option. It will enable your system, so the vMix software, to use less of your system CPU. Okay, and then when you're recording also, you also see the option here. It's always here, use hardware encoder. You can also see it on the streaming tab if your PC is dedicated graphics. I always enable that option so your vMix will utilize less of the system resources and enable your streaming to work perfectly fine and without the system lagging as well. And then your recording size, also keep the resolution lower as well, maybe something like 720 also. And then the per frame rate, you can also do that. If you're recording on MP4, just keep it low. And the bit rate, don't take it too high, just take it a bit low so that it will enable the vMix software to utilize just a list of the system resources instead of a very large, making it of a very large system resources as well. Okay, and the video bitrate, you can also keep it low depending on the quality of your capture card. Okay, some uses easy card, you can see that here. Some use it other graphics, other capture card as well that supports 1080, while others uses some that support only HDMI, and the rest, some of them that also support only SDI. Okay, so I'll also be sharing with you the one I use and also how to set it up as well. Click around and subscribe to my YouTube channel if you haven't, and also turn on the notification bell when you subscribe so you will always be notified. Don't also forget to give this video a thumbs up, so by so doing you are recommending this video to other people as well who would also want to know or rather learn more about vMix.